moving on, the next panel on RE financing, and especially with respect to debt finance. May I take this opportunity to invite our distinguished panelists, and we're deeply honored and privileged to have experts on this matter will be talking with us on this. Mr. Karan Mitroo, who our chair of this session, he's the partner at Luthra and Luthra. Mr. Abhilakh Singh ji, GM, Indian Renewable Energy Development Authority, IREDA. Mr. Gaurav Joshi, he's from the World Bank and working as Senior Environmental Specialist, Environmental and Natural Resource Global Practice Team. Mr. Alipt from GEF, and Mr. Debal Mitra, Senior Vice President, Risk from SREI. So I believe in the distributed solar space, just to enlighten the audience with some happenings, lots and lots of things have had taken place this year. Announcement by the minister in Munich that Varanasi will be the first 100% solar powered city, and later on we'll have many cities as 100% solar powered cities. Then we had the Saubhagya scheme launched by the government, announced by our Prime Minister, an outlay of 16,000 crores. And very, very recently, World Bank and SBI announced a big incentive package for the financing of rooftops. So moving on to the RE finance session, may I kindly request our session panelists to take their seats on the dais, starting with our session chair, Mr. Karan Mitroo, Mr. Abhilakh Singh, Mr. Alip Sharma, Mr. Gaurav Joshi, and Mr. Debal Mitra. Do we also have Mr. Neeraj Jain from SBI Caps in the room? If he's there, please come to the stage. Mr. Debal Mitra, Senior Vice President from SREI Infra Finance. Can I request you to please come on the stage? I kindly request everyone to please settle down. I assure you there will be lots and lots of networking time once this session gets over. Kindly request everyone to settle down, please, so that we can begin this session on RE financing and debt finance. Thank you. Over to Mr. Karan Mitroo.
Hi, good evening, everyone. I usually, the last session is a bit cramped up and should be the shortest. So I think the intent of the panel is also to keep it relevant and brief. I'm Karan Mitroo. I'm a partner with a law firm called Luthra and Luthra Law Offices, which is a full service law firm across New Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, and a small office in Hyderabad. Although we have all services available within the firm, my specialization is debt and structured finance, as well as a bit of equity. We've been in this space advising all sorts of stakeholders, be it developers, lenders, investors, contract negotiations on EPC, O&M, as well as certain tax advisory. And we've been doing it for the past 6 to 7 years since the sector has been sort of booming. And I share my personal views after the introductions, but all in all, I think it is one of the sunrise sectors still in the Indian economy, in spite of the turbulence we're facing in the other sectors. With that, I just request the panel members to first introduce themselves.
Good evening. My name is Gaurav Joshi. I work as an environmental specialist in the New Delhi's office of the World Bank. I have been associated with the solar program that the bank has supported since we started working several years ago with a proposal that has now morphed into actually an investment operation with IREDA as our partner. So it's been a long, tortuous journey, but we've kind of traversed. Not all of it is rooftop, though there is the big rooftop that the last session at the end mentioned. It's a large program. I have the pleasure of looking at it from both an environmental perspective and also as a team member, so I hope I'd be able to contribute something meaningful to the conversation. Thank you.
Good evening to everyone. I am Abhilakh Singh, General Manager IREDA. I am looking after the technical division, which includes all technical means business group, solar, wind, hydro, and IT also. So as you know, IREDA, I think most of you very well aware about the IREDA, and IREDA has been doing financing for last 30 years. This is the 31st year we have entered, and so I'll make a presentation or whatever the discussion point comes.
Hi, I'm Alipt Sharma from the Global Environment Fund. We are global investors in the areas of resource efficiency, and one of our key investment verticals is renewable energy. Our focus is primarily on emerging markets. We do regions like LATAM, Eastern Europe, China, and India, South Asia. Kind of a misfit on this panel because we are equity investors, not really debt investors. But we've seen, as investors, we kind of keenly see the developments on the debt side, both on the utility scale and the distributed energy side, because that plays a key role. Leverage plays a key role in all our investment decisions. So happy to contribute my views on the space.
Yeah, good evening, everybody. I am Debal Mitra. I am working with SREI Infrastructure Finance Limited as the head of risk. So it is, for some of you who might be knowing, SREI is an accredited infrastructure finance company, which is basically an NBFC which has 75% of its loan book in infrastructure, as an infrastructure sector. So renewable actually forms a relatively smaller portion. We want to grow in that trajectory, of course, the conditions willing. So I would probably have more things to say in my presentation, I guess.
So I'd actually just like to take off from something that Anuvrat mentioned in the last panel discussion. He's not here, but he mentioned that there is an oversupply of funds in the IPP space. In my past experience over the last 9 months to 1 year, I don't think that's the correct statement, but I just sort of like to get your views, Abhilakh and Mr. Mitra, on that, considering that you are heavy debt financiers. Are you still funding the IPP projects as heavily as you were about a year and a half or 2 years ago?
Well, frankly speaking, as I said, we wanted to move into this space in a big way, because given energy would always remain a major part of the infrastructure, and we were not seeing any traction whatsoever in the conventional power. However, renewable energy, given the kind of disruptive events that we have seen in the recent past, it is not only us, but it is also, and I believe from the, you know, the transactions which are happening or not happening, that some amount of friction has come about in that matter, and obviously the sector is getting reformatted, and one has to, there, as I was try to, you know, elaborate in my presentation, that there are a lot of positives which are also coming, which are coexisting or which are co-happening with the negatives which are there. So unless and until this entire morass gets kind of cleared up, we won't really see that kind of a thrust, which probably even 1 year back, lenders would have felt encouraged to go into.
Yes, IREDA has been doing the business as usual, and this year's target is 13,000 crore. And so far we have sanctioned around 5,700 crore, and hopefully by this month end we should be able to around 7,500 crore. And if we go to the disbursement side, we have a target of 8,000 crore for this year, 8,100 crore. And out of that, till today, it is around 4,700 crore we have done it. So if we take half yearly, I think we are progressing very well. And as far as IPP concerned, as you asked, so IREDA has been doing and this projects. So I don't think this big size, bigger size of projects is possible within the actually company. So it is not definitely possible. So most of the projects are actually IPP, maybe very small project, 1 or 2 megawatt. Those may be in the existing company, but generally those are also not in an existing company. Normally, because of existing company, then there are many issues. So anybody will prefer that this that they should go for IPP.
Okay. The World Bank's disbursement targets are contingent on what the government of India thinks it will be able to disburse, right? We don't actually go to individuals and can not do individual loans. So probably an IREDA or a SECI would be our partner of choice. Depending on what the TEA decides, we will do. And then the speed at which solar has taken off. We have been involved in two solar plants, one in Rewa and one in Mandsaur. Those are taking off well, but our loan with IREDA is still in the process of being negotiated for some commercial aspects, namely the fees that are involved between transfer of those funds to the MP, New and Renewable Energy Department, and IREDA, because they are now a company, right? So they have their commercial thinking that needs to go into it. So once that gets sorted out, we will be done. But in SBI, where SBI lends the monies we have lent to them directly to sub-loans. Yesterday you saw some 2,000 whatever crores, but that is mostly rooftops. But I understand that those are mostly big, chunky companies which have taken, 20, 25 megawatts, that kind of thing. So that is where the motion is. The parks are going ahead at their own speeds. We are in no position to influence that. And the government of India draws on our money only as a reimbursement. So in the pure term, we're not exactly a lender in the way a commercial lender like an SREI finance would be.
Thanks. And we get into the entire SBI and the IREDA disbursements in a while as well. I think the question for you on the equity side, again, something similar. We've seen a lot of interest in this area about 2 or 3 years ago. What is your take on the sector as of now, and where would you like to see your investments in this particular sector?
Sure. So I think it's important to bifurcate the space between utility and distributed. I think the utility story has played out very well from both the equity and debt side. What we saw as challenges maybe 4 or 5 years back, and we've in India invested in some of the largest IPP, so Greenco and Renew are our portfolio companies in India. And 7-8 years back, debt used to be a challenge. It used to be a challenge both in terms of tenor and the utilities' understanding of what renewable energy was. So they were only comfortable financing wind. And it's quite a departure from those days, because we call these forums Cleantech forums, but we only end up talking about solar. Wind kind of becomes a stepchild now. So we've seen the transition from those days where now as a utility, I think it's fair to say that debt is easily available and various forms. So refinancing is available. You can, you know, a lot of those structured instruments overseas are available. Both GreenCo and Renew have had green bond offerings overseas. So from a debt side, there are various options available to utility scale players. I think the challenge comes on the distributed solar side. And I was actually pleasantly surprised when people on the previous panel said that debt was easily available for rooftop. I think that is still a challenge in our views as equity investors when it comes to maybe debt which is given to the utility that is implementing distributed solar rather than the end customer. See, a Grasim or an ACC using their credit to get loan for a rooftop project is very different from a pure utility that is only focused on distributed energy getting, say, project financing, which is covers their entire portfolio and doesn't get into the credit quality of each individual customer that they have or the PPA that they have. And the challenge there is that you have much smaller units, right? The unit that you're dealing with as compared to grid connected, where you can now have 100, 200 megawatt projects, you have extremely small capacities on the distributed side. So I think that is still, as equity investors for us, we're still not fully convinced on how easily that debt will be available. And it'll be interesting for me to know from the fellow panelists here what their views are in terms of financing the distributed solar space. So I think utility scale, both on wind and solar, we are very comfortable and very bullish, you know, investing more and more capital. I think what holds us back is not demand, but the whole capital structuring piece and, you know, and some bit of those issues with the DISCOMs which people alluded to. I think those are two critical factors which today are maybe holding both equity and debt investors back when it comes to the distributed solar space.
Okay, it's interesting you mentioned wind being the stepchild. That was something that we wanted to talk about a bit on this panel again. So yeah, we have seen solar funding, and I sort of agree with what Mr. Mitra was saying, that there is a slowdown, I feel, at least in the PSUs and the private sector banks in India as of now, primarily because of the issues vis-a-vis GST or anti-dumping or customs or the tariff renegotiations or the entire non-signing of the PPAs. I mean, there are a host of these issues. And a lot of private and public sector banks, in my understanding, have become jittery in this sector for now on debt financing. Coupled with that, after the issuance of those bonds by GreenCo and Renew, the entire masala bond regime has now come under the RBI approval route, which just makes it all the more tougher for that financing to come forth. But on the wind space, are you comfortable funding wind projects, especially after what the Karnataka government has done in the last few days of overturning the tariff renegotiations by KERC? Does that sort of give you confidence to fund these projects?
See, now the issues, definitely it is a very serious issue, and then for PPA is to be renegotiated, and definitely it is not comfortable situation for the financiers. However, at present actually new projects are not coming. So now refinancing and take out financing, so many things are going on. Still, actually now so far we have not stopped funding this wind sector. So wind and solar most likely both are parallel actually, and the quantity is also the same. Maybe around what I said, 5700 crore we have sanctioned. Out of that, I think 2500 or between 3000 maybe wind and solar and some other hydro and cogeneration. So as such, this situation is not comfortable, but still we are doing it. And Karnataka, I don't think in last 2-3 months any project we have actually received specifically. And Tamil Nadu and this Tamil Nadu and Andhra, there is no issue we have been doing, and we are continuing doing.
Yeah, I too have a feeling that, you know, when we are talking about, as I said, that this was a sector which was supposed to be, you know, which we had sort of pitted as a sunrise, not to say that, I mean, I'm talking about the, you know, the entire renewables. In terms of the prospects, in terms of the sheer support from the government. Now, this particular situation, like what you said about the KERC, sort of renegotiating the tariff from 4.5 to 3.74. Now that was not something which had been envisaged, and that is for me. It's, I would tend to think that it's a huge setback, because I have had a chance to talk to you know, a few developers. Now they are saying that the issue about this wind being moved from FIT to the competitive bidding is something that they can take. They can consider, because they are mature. They know how to, you know, price, and it's a good thing for them. And it's being so. It's probably, you know, it would separate the wheat from the chaff, which would not probably have been the case in the earlier solar, you know, bids, which were very aggressive. You know, so that maturity they feel has come, but it is in the in the reneging of the contract by the, you know, the sub-sovereign, by the, you know, the state governments and the state government bodies, you know, that is something which is, you know, really galling them. And if that is the case for the developers, then obviously they are the ones who had planned the projects on the ground. So we lenders, of course, we also sort of conquer, because, you know, now, you know, the workings and the models are all kind of similar. So it doesn't really work out. And that is that particular thing, not so much the you know, bringing the wind into the, you know, the competitive bidding framework, but the contract renegotiation thing, that is something which is of concern, I would say.